บาดมาใครเหลือเบื้องสังสื่อช่องเขาก็ว่าว่ามีเจอระจีเสา
I don't know of any experience where the basic demand of indigenous peoples have been to separate from the country. Their demands have been for justice. Their demands have been for their rights. Their demands have been for all of the basic needs which all peoples have. It has not been a demand for separation. It hasn't been a demand to be isolated. On the contrary, they have time and time again exhibited their faith that governments will act fairly. Why have they been for decades going to the United Nations, which is a body of governments, with their demands if they did not believe that governments could respond fairly and justly to those demands? And that's the faith which ought not now be betrayed by governments, but rather upheld by governments. We should demonstrate, governments should demonstrate, that in fact that faith was well placed, that when governments are presented with facts and with reality, rather than with fear-mongering or rhetoric, that they will respond in the way that will uphold the rights of all peoples.
We don't have any problem with the declaration in its current form. The concerns that some countries have raised about sovereignty, we believe, have been addressed with reference, clear reference made to the charters.
No pretendemos separarnos de los estados, hacer otros estados, argumentando soberanía. No pretendemos crear ejércitos, no pretendemos crear o delimitar y no dejar paso, crear murallas, nada de eso. Por lo cual nosotros como pueblos indígenas no queremos que se nos elimine así por nomás, porque sí, por unos intereses de unas cuantas personas, de cuantos capitalistas o algunos ambiciosos del poder.
Además, todos los países ya tenemos una constitución, que es la ley máxima que rige nuestros estados. Esta declaración no va en contra de ninguna constitución.
It's just a declaration, it's not even a legally binding convention.
Darle derechos a los pueblos indígenas es ayudarlos a que sobrevivan como pueblos indígenas, es ayudarlos a que busquen cómo proteger su diversidad cultural, cómo proteger sus recursos y sus tierras. Nosotros consideramos que la declaración, que el texto de la declaración como está, tiene ese objetivo. Tiene el objetivo de proteger a los pueblos indígenas, de darles derechos y de atender sus necesidades más básicas para sobrevivir.
And by governments trying to dilute the rights of indigenous peoples and trying to say that indigenous peoples have less rights than other peoples is discriminatory and racist.
The states may ask, why would we ask for self-determination? We're asking for self-determination as a people because we are a people. We are Navajos. The answer is as simple as that. We may live in the United States. Others may consider us citizens of the United States. Others may consider us to be part of that evolution of the melting pot. That's all fine and dandy, but the reality is we are Navajos. We speak our language. We have a set of values and beliefs and ways of looking at the world that is fundamentally different from those expressed in the United States through its various institutions, policies, and constitutions. And so what is good for us as a nation, as a people, is quite different from those exercised for the health of the United States. And we do need self-determination as a people so that we can remain Navajos.
El tema de la exclusión y por lo tanto la pobreza, pues es un tema de una mala relación entre los estados y los pueblos indígenas. Este documento lo que busca es apoyar a los países a que tengan una mejor relación con sus pueblos indígenas. Mi mensaje va para los países que tienen población indígena y tienen dudas respecto a la declaración. No manden un mal mensaje a sus pueblos indígenas. Un mensaje en contra de la declaración puede ser una pérdida de la esperanza y la búsqueda de otras vías para reconocer sus derechos.
It's clear that the declaration is not a treaty, and one would be fair in asking the question, well, if it's not a treaty with binding legal obligations, what is the value of this instrument? One is that this is an extremely useful tool for those of us who work in human rights, because it is in many ways a harvest as well that has reaped existing fruits from a number of treaties and declarations and guidelines and bodies of principle, but importantly also from the jurisprudence of the human rights bodies that have been set up by the United Nations and charged with monitoring the implementation of the various treaties. The rights that are contained in the declaration are not new. There are no new rights in the declaration from our perspective. They are rights that have been codified by the member states of this organization in countless treaties and have existed for the entire life of this organization since the adoption of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. But they are rights that have been violated, if we are to be frank, with impunity vis-a-vis indigenous people for as long as those rights have existed. So the declaration does something very, very useful. It helps us to clarify what are the normative implications and the operational requirements, if I may say so, of the existing catalog of human rights standards that have been adopted by the United Nations through the years, and in a way which is situation specific, which helps to clarify how these rights, existing, pre-existing rights, apply to the very particular case of indigenous peoples around the world. Another value is that the declaration is comprehensive. It covers the full range of rights of indigenous peoples, in fact, rights of all of us, but as they relate to indigenous peoples, and catalogs the kinds of violations that have historically and sadly continue to plague indigenous peoples around the world, in particular attacks upon their culture and their land and their identity, and if I can put it this way, upon their own voice. With remarkable detail on issues like cross-border relations and discrimination suffered by indigenous groups. So in short, the declaration lays out the minimum standards for the survival, dignity, and well-being of indigenous peoples.
Really, it is a very balanced document, meeting in a fair way the legitimate interest of the indigenous peoples, but also the legitimate interest of states.
The Declaration on the Rights of the Indigenous Peoples is an achievement. It is the result of negotiations between governments on one side and representatives of indigenous peoples on the other side, and in that it is already unique.